things start bringing on the wild ride.
Well, the world's largest technology conference for people with disabilities comes to San Diego for the first time. Big companies are here to showcase new cutting-edge technology assistance for those who need help. And Sandy Plotin is here from Center on Disabilities, and you are from Cal State Northridge.
Yes, I am.
And you're also the host of this huge event here in San Diego. And then we have Vicki Essner, Nevada Service to the Blind. And Vicki, you know, you have a really long title for yourself, so can you tell me what it is?
It's the Department of Employment, Training, and Rehabilitation, Bureau of the Services to the Blind and Visually Impaired, where employment is the goal.
Okay, and you also have these devices that are kind of already making noise in your head, and that's okay because we're going to showcase those in a minute. So if we hear them in the background, that's fine, because it's all about assistive technology, this event, which started actually yesterday, goes through Saturday at the Manchester Grand Hyatt, and for the first time in San Diego. Talk about kind of the scope of things. This is attracting people worldwide.
Absolutely. We're really excited to be in your city. It was a win-win situation for us to find a new venue that could hold us all in one hotel, and we have just found the city so welcoming, and it's so accessible to our participants that we just love it.
And this is a 25th milestone, assistive technology. How has it evolved over 25 years? And Vicki, you can probably answer that as well.
25 years ago, we had 200 people on the Cal State Northridge campus. From there, it grew into the premier event for anybody who was interested in this field, and the opportune time for when it started was really important because that's when technology was starting to emerge. And it brought people together who were developing the technology with the people who needed it.
Okay, and Vicki, being vision impaired, you have these devices in your hand. These are two of the new technology that are going to be displayed at this event?
Yes.
Okay, so tell us about it. We heard one of them talking.
This is the BlackBerry Tor running the Oratio app on it. Mm-hmm. And
map location grid screen.
As you hear it talking,
James.
It is mainly for the blind and vision impaired, letting us be able to do our address book, navigate our emails, surf the web, but also all of the features that you do with a smartphone, I'm able now to use the camera feature and magnify the information and kind of use it as a magnifying device as well. If you're wondering, the keys on the BlackBerry Tor are so small, they built in an app that lets you go into key describer mode, and I teach the individuals that I serve how to learn the keys and navigate at their own pace, using the voice technology.
Okay, and then you have another one in your hand as well.
The Victor Reader Stream, it's a book playback device, but it also lets me record my meetings, scheduled events, so I don't miss anything. As an instructor, a trainer, and a vocation, being in the professional world, I need to make sure I don't miss meetings.
Well, that's
along with listening to playback books and keep current with the training I do.
Well, that's terrific. You know, this is just two of many that you're going to be talking about. You have these big companies here. You have Apple, you have Microsoft showing all of this technology. And then talk about, you have one special event, too, with this bike ride.
Oh, this is exciting. And this is going to be one time in a lifetime. So everybody's got to come to the hotel to see this. Eric Williams, who's a recent Cal State Northridge grad, is a quadriplegic. He's going to be hand cycling from the campus. He's leaving today at noon. Big send-off from the campus. He's arriving in San Diego on Thursday at 12. We want everybody to come out from the city and greet him. And it's just a fantastic thing he's doing because it's for charity.
Yeah, that's terrific.
And it's for military families, veterans, and it's just, he's going to tweet all the way. So we'll have that posted on our website, so we want everybody to follow his trip.
Okay, so he'll be arriving on Thursday. Mm-hmm. And you also, you have these great keynote speakers and everything for this event, which goes through Saturday, I believe, the 27th.
Correct.
What do you want people to get out of this? You have a worldwide audience. You have people coming from all over the world. What do you hope they take away from it?
Well, I hope they take away information. Anything they are coming to the conference for, they will find at our conference. We have exhibitors, we have general sessions, and the most important thing that we have at the conference is networking. And if you don't find it in the general sessions, if you don't find it in the educational workshops, you will find it from talking to the people in the halls.
And as a recipient of the ATACP, I completed that coursework from Cal State University. The programs that are available and the instructors are fabulous, along with the technology that helps individuals like myself maintain employment. There is hope for individuals with disabilities.
All right, thank you so much, ladies. I really appreciate it. Sandy, Vicki, best of luck to you for this conference, and thanks for showing off these wonderful items.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We appreciate you being here.
Very welcome.
All right. For more information on it, then we go to sandiego6.com and click on Hot Topics, and it will link them to more information.
Terrific.
All right.